This is a really big moment for Blue Origin. Can you tell me how NG2 compares to NG1?
Yeah, I think NG1 was obviously our first mission. There was lots to learn, and we did learn a lot, and you know, unbelievably successful in that we made our goal, which was to get to orbit. This time, we're going to be a little bit more ambitious. We want to not only get to orbit, but we have our first paying customer this time with Escapade and get them off to Mars. That's the first part of our goal. And then the second part of the goal is to land the booster out on Jacqueline. And you know, if we don't, we have more over here in the factory that we're building, but we're going to give it our best shot.
And can we talk about kind of how hardware rich we really are right now?
Yeah, the production team has done such good work that even from the last time we chatted, we have, I think, 8 upper stages in work over here. We have a couple sets of engines that we're working on right now, in addition to the engines that we've shipped over to ULA at this point. And we have multiple boosters in work, too. So, you know, the goal is to get to a much faster cadence as we learn each of these flights. So we're going to continue to get faster and as we go along.
Never Tell Me the Odds is pretty fitting for this booster. You know, we are taking our second attempt at landing it for the first time. How are you going to feel if we land it?
Well, I certainly will not channel my inner C-3PO. I will be very ecstatic. You know, I'll be on pins and needles up to that point, but it would be a huge achievement for the team and for Blue. I think that we have a good chance, but if we don't, like I said, we can build more, but I will be over the moon if it happens.
Now, New Glenn is obviously just one of the many systems we have here, right? We have New Shepard, we have Lunar, we have InSpace Systems. How are all of those organizations really working together to further our ultimate goals?
Yeah, I think each component of what we do has a piece of trying to get millions of people to work and live in space. And, you know, they all have their individual, but as it relates to this particular mission, a huge amount of people have put work into it. Obviously, our engines team in building both the engines for the booster, the BE-4s, and the BE-3Us for the upper stage. We also have a huge amount of work by the, obviously, New Glenn team building this vehicle, but also New Shepard has been a pathfinder. So all our avionics fly on New Shepard first so that we can get a sense of what's going on there and get a sense what it's like to have flight-ready hardware. And so it takes a whole team, and it's a very big cross-functional effort across Blue.
We have our motto, right? Gradatum ferociter. How has that really kind of gotten us to the point where we are today, and how is it going to take us further?
We have a philosophy that if we can test on the ground, we're going to test on the ground, and we're going to try to get things as flight-like as we possibly can. There's some things that we can only test in flight, and NG1 was a good example of that. We flew it, we learned a lot, we've made the changes, and now we'll get to fly again. But I think that if we can methodically build, but also do it in a way that we have a decisiveness and urgency, we can really achieve the goal of building the world's best manufacturing company. And that's what it's going to take to sort of be able to drive this audacious mission of getting millions of people into space. And I see the progress every day. You know, when you look out at the factory floor here or you're in Huntsville, I try to get to all the factories as much as I can. You just start seeing they're beginning to get their feet under them, and they're starting to hum like a factory that's a well-oiled machine.
And this is something that is important to you being at the helm for the past 2 years. You know, you and I got to talk briefly earlier, but you said how important it was for it to function that way, to be manufacturing.
I think anybody can build a prototype of something. I mentioned that to you last time. It's even a prototype rocket, you can probably, you know, brute force your way through. But building a lot of something, you have to build the machine that makes that machine. And it's a harder task, actually. And if you walk a factory, you can tell a factory when it's got a life to it, when it's starting to hum. You can also tell a factory is broken.
Right, you're hearing that hum. And within that, you know, we have more than 10,000 employees here that are very excited about this moment. I'm one of them. What is your message to those who are going to be watching our webcast and be watching NG2 take to the skies?
Well, I think everybody will be a little bit on pins and needles, I'm sure. But I would say that this is a culmination of a lot of work from a lot of teams. It's not the end point of our journey. Obviously, we have a lot more rockets to make and a lot more customers to make happy as we move forward. But to the extent we're successful here, I hope everybody at Team Blue takes a pause, smiles a bit, celebrates, because it'll be a great achievement for us. And we'll take that deep breath. We'll sort of embrace the moment and then move on, because we have a lot of customers waiting for us to succeed. And there's nothing that makes you happier in business and in your life when you see the smile on customers' faces.
I mean, yeah, speaking of that, customer focus is a big part of what we do here. Escapade being our first customer, NASA being our first customer. How do we intend to use what we learn from this launch and to continue to build great relationships with our customers?
Well, I'm super excited about our relationship with NASA. We obviously have it across many parts of our business, including lunar and other places. And having the privilege of getting them on their way to Mars is just so amazing. And I think that this science mission embodies what NASA is great at, which is partnerships and being able to be a little bit more scrappy and do science projects at a price point that hadn't always been able to achieve. So being a little part of that is great. But obviously, as we can get more and more successful getting payloads to orbit, I think that gives confidence for other customers. I've never seen such a high demand for a launch than right now. And so it's great to see, but it means we have to execute and get our cadence of launch higher and higher.
Did you ever think that you would be doing something like this in your career?
No.
You're watching your rockets launch? No?
No, not in a million years. I was very happy making Fire TVs and Echoes, but it is a boyhood dream. And so to be able to have it, I kind of pinched myself every day and just amazed that I get to wake up and help this and lead this amazing team of people build incredible technology like New Glenn.
I mean, and reference to that, one of the first things they ask you when you come onto Blue Origin is, what is your first memory of space? What is your first memory of space?
Yeah, I have a lot of pictures. It turned out my third, fourth, and fifth birthday, I have these old Polaroids of the cake, and they all have rockets on it. I was enamored with rockets as a kid and never took the path where I thought I'd be running a rocket or a rocket company. But right. It turns out that it was very early in my life that I had a lot of love for it.
And we're so grateful to have you here at the helm. Dave, thank you so much for your time.
Thanks.
I appreciate it.
Yeah.